वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर गीता सचदेवा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी कुरुक्षेत्रा। द टॉपिक विच आई एम गोइंग टू कवर इज वर्क स्ट्रेस। बेसिकली इन दिस चैप्टर आई विल डिस्कस मैनेजिंग स्ट्रैटेजीज टू कॉप अप विद स्ट्रेस। अंडर दिस आई विल डिस्कस इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट, इंडिविजुअल अप्रोचेज टू मैनेज द स्ट्रेस, ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल अप्रोचेज टू मैनेज द स्ट्रेस, 4A टू डील विद स्ट्रेस, and apart from this I will discuss some basic strategies to manage the stress. After the completion of this module, students will be able to understand individual and organizational approaches to manage the stress. Regrettably, most of us disagree the presence of our stress till it is too late. This escaping strategy generates a malicious circle because the failure to handle with stress become extra stressor on the top of the one that generated the stress in the initial place. As we observe at each approach, keep in notice that both organization and employee share combined accountability for effective stress management. Furthermore, managing stress frequently contains more than one of these strategies. Firstly, I will discuss with you individual approaches to manage the stress. First individual approach to manage the stress is knowledge about stress. In the early stage, an individual should become educated about stress. He should be familiar with the procedure and effects of stress. He must discover out the key sources of stress. He must expect stressful time and plan therefore in advance. He must be honest with himself, decide what he can manage and what he cannot. Second strategy to manage the stress is physiological fitness. Workout in any form can help person in coping with the stress. Non-competitive physical workout recommended by physicians as a technique to deal with extreme stress levels. Third technique is time management. Generally, persons are very poor in handling their time. They do not see that what must be completed, when it would be desired to do so. The result of poor time management is sensation of work excess, miss out plans and strains. A sound managed individual can often finish twice as much as the individual who is poorly organized. Next, individual strategy to manage the stress is assertiveness. A person should be assertive. He should not say yes when he desired to say no. He should start saying no to person or bosses who demand abundant of his time. Next technique is social support network. Every individual should have persons to turn to talk and trust upon. Good friends become enormously cooperative through times of stress emergency. Social network comprises friends, family and co-workers. Enhancing social network system could be a source for tension decline because friends are there when required and provide sustenance to get the individual out through stressful conditions. Next strategy is readjust life goals. Each person must recognize what he really wants to do. This should link to not only the key judgments of the life but to all activities in their lives. He must distinguish what is important for him. Because of the severe competition in the life to go forward, many persons get great criteria and aims for themselves. These high projections and limited resources to reach at such anticipation result in stress. Henceforth, each individual must readapt his goals and confirm that he has the ability and means to reach at such aims. Next one is relaxation techniques. Each person must teach himself to reduce tension through relaxation method like yoga, meditation. Deep relaxation methods make imperative change in the heart rate, blood pressure and other physical factors. Next individual approach to manage the stress is plan your life in advance. Most of the times person makes situations which yield in stress since they either did not plot or did a poor job of planning. The traditional Indian attitude of whatsoever will be, a method of accepting the unexpected difficulties in life. this attitude might be relevant in those circumstances over which we do not have any control, such as death in the family. But for more activities in life, it is better to plan in advance so that we can handle them with self-confidence when they occur. Next individual approach is live each day well. Combine activity, thought, and a positive attitude approaching the lot of things that must be done each day. Celebrate special occasions, undertake new experiences, learn from your mistakes. Next one is anticipate problems and see yourself as a problem solver. Though each specific problem is unique, it is most likely similar to past ones. Use these past experiences to quickly recognize ways of resolving new problems. Next approach is search for solutions. Act on a partial solution, even when a complete solution seems far away. By resolving some aspect of a problem, we can achieve time for more focused contemplation of the leftover complexities. In addition, some development is a confidence builder that can help us to remain committed to finding a complete solution. Next individual approach is social interaction. While social interaction has been shown to have positive results on decreasing the effects of stress, this beneficial effect depends on the type of friends with whom we surround ourselves. Spending time with negative, pessimistic people can augment our stress level rather than reducing it. It is visibly more beneficial to enclose ourselves with positive and hopeful friends. Next individual approach to manage the stress is combating perfectionism. Perfectionism is frequently connected with obsessive compulsive disorder, OCD, as well as with eating disorders. Having perfectionist tendencies can also generate stress and conflict in relationships because people who interact with perfectionists feel as though nothing they do is good enough or will satisfy the person. To help ease the stress of perfectionism, base our self-esteem on whom we are rather than what we do. This involves accepting ourselves and others unconditionally, including imperfections, decreasing our expectation of ourselves and others, and aiming for 80% rather than 100% is one more strategy in fighting perfectionism. Consider what we are doing well and have achieved rather than what is still left to do. Push ourselves to take risks and allow ourselves to commit mistakes. It can be helpful to make mistakes on purpose in order to get used to this experience and realize that people still like and accept you and nothing bad will happen. Then we will cover organizational approaches to manage stress. First organizational approach is remove the stressor. From the list of stress management strategies, many authors debate that only the method that organization can effectively manage stress is by eliminating the stressor that create unnecessary pressure and job exhaustion. Additional stress management strategies might keep employees stress fit, but they do not resolve the central sources of stress. Next strategies on the organization part is change the corporate culture and reward system. More commonly, research has established that one of the greatest influential methods to eliminate office stressor is to allow employees so that they have more control over their work and their environment. Next one is role-related stressor. Role-related stressors can be reduced by choosing and allocating employees to positions that match with their capabilities. Noise and safety risks are stressful, so enlightening these circumstances would also go a lengthy way to diminish stress in the place of work. Next, workplace bullying can be diminished with the help of clear rules of behavior and feedback for those who defy those principles. Next organizational approach is family, friend, and work-life initiatives. Organizations around the country are messing up to make a family-friendly workplace that objects to increase work-life balance. Several organizations claim to provide a work-life balance. Most common work-life balance ingenuities are stretchy work time, job sharing, teleworking, individual leave and child care amenities. Next strategy is flexible work time. Many companies are flexible about the hours, days and amount of time employees want to work. For instance, some organization offer life program provides the employees the autonomy to recognize their work schedule, to manage family events, from attending their kids' sports activities to caring for elderly parents. Next strategy is job sharing. Job sharing bridges a career position between two people, so they experience less time-based stress between work and the family. They usually work diverse portion of the week with some overlapping work time in the weekly schedule to coordinate activities. Next one is telecommuting. It reduces the time and stress of traveling to workplace and makes it cooler to fulfill family duties. For example, momentarily leaving the home office to pick the child up from school. Research recommends that teleworkers experience an improved work-life balance. Though telecommuting might absorb stress for those who desire social interaction, it also is not a resolution for childcare. Personal leave programs. Employers with robust work-life values offer stretched maternity, paternity, and personal leaves to care for a new family or take gain of personal experience. Progressively, employees need personal leave to care for elderly parents who need support. Next, organizational approach to manage the stresses, selection and placement. Persons differ in their reactions to stress circumstances. Type A persons are more probable to face stress. On the other side, in the companies, there are numerous jobs which are more demanding in contrast to other jobs. So while doing the selection and placement of the employees, these matters must be reserved in mind. The person who are more probable to have stress might adjust better to high stress jobs and act upon those jobs effectively. Next one is goal setting. Grounded on wide amount of research, it has been determined that person perform better when they have exact and challenging aims and they gain feedback on how well they are going forward toward those aims. Goal setting can reduce stress as well as provide motivation. It will result in fewer employee annoyance, role vagueness and stress. Next strategy on the part of organization is improved communication. Many times because absence of effective communication from their bosses, the employees do not recognize what they have to perform and how they have to perform it. This ends in role ambiguity. Similarly, when two or more persons have conflicting role demands from an employee, it leads to role conflict if there is absence of proper communication. Effective communication with employees decreases ambiguity by lessening the role ambiguity and role conflict. Next approach is redesigning jobs. Companies should reshape the jobs in such a way as to provide employees more accountability, more expressive work, more independence, routine work, work overload or underload and role ambiguity. Job redesigning upsurges motivation, reduces the stress among us employees and increases quality of work life. Next approach is participative decision making. If the companies provide the employees contribution in those decisions that straight affect them and their job performance, it can raise employee control and decrease the role stress. The key cause of the role stress is that employees feel ambiguous about their objectives, prospects, and how they will be assessed. These doubts can be lessened by the management by providing the employees a right to partake in their decision making. Next approach is building teamwork. The management should attempt to create such work environment in which there is no criteria for interpersonal fight or intergroup fight. Such conflicts are the reasons of stress. Such should be clogged from building or eliminated if they grow. Therefore, such work should be established that groups and the members are mutually cooperative and creative. Participants of the group should trust themselves as participants of the related family and search for substance from each other. Next one is persona wellness programs. Personal wellness program focus on employees' total physical and mental condition. Companies can give conveniences at their locations for physical fitness, for example, gym, swimming pool, tennis court, etc., as well as psychometric counseling. companies should conduct seminars or workshops to make the employee identify nature and causes of stress and the possible approaches to cut it. These workshops should help those persons who are already under stress. Moreover, a manager can influence the personal wellness of subordinates with positive instances, support, and by performing the indispensable ideas and methods of human resource management. Next, organizational approach to manage the stress is withdrawal from stressor. Eliminating the stressor might be the perfect solution, but it is frequently not possible. An alternate strategy is to forever or momentarily eliminate employees from the stressor. Enduring withdrawal happens when employees are transmitted to jobs that better fit their capabilities and values. Next is temporary withdrawal strategies. Temporarily withdrawing from stressor is the utmost recurrent method employees cope up stress. Nortel Networks has a relaxation room ample with comfortable chairs and amusement videos where employees can momentarily drip from the noise of work. Days off and holidays characterize somewhat lengthier momentary withdrawals from stressful circumstances. One study of a police and emergency responses service employees' capability to manage with work-related stress. Then change stress perceptions. Employees commonly experience varied degrees of stress in the similar condition because they identify it inversely. As a consequence, stress can be reduced by altering perception of condition. This does not include overlooking risk or other stressor. Rather, we can reinforce our self-efficacy and self-esteem so that job challenges are not perceived as intimidating. Humor can also advance our perception by taking some psychological way of the conditions. Next, organizational approach is to control the consequence of stress. Managing with workplace stress also include controlling its consequences. For this cause, many organizations have fitness centers where employees can maintain in shape. Research specifies that physical exercise decreases the physical consequences of stress by assisting employees lessen their breathing, muscle tensions, heartbeat, and stomach acidity. Another method to control the physiological consequence of stress is through relaxation and meditation. Generally, these actions lower down the person's heart rate, blood pressure, muscle tension, and breathing rate. Whereas fitness and relaxation meditation are still significant, many companies have shifted to the wider method of wellness programs which instruct and assist employees in better nutrition and fitness, steady sleep and other good health habits. Next one is EPAs. Many big companies give EPAs, Employees Assistance Programs. EPAs are counseling services that assist employees overcome personal or work stressors and accept more effective handling mechanism. Most EPAs are broad brush programs that advise employees on any work or personal problems. Family problems frequently signify the main percentage of EPAs referrals, though these differ with organization and location. Next approach is to manage the stress from the organization part is receive social support. Social support from colleagues, managers, family, friends and other is one of the more effective stress management practices. It states to the individual's interpersonal relationship with others and includes giving either emotional or informational substance to buffer the stress experience. Social support decreases stress in three ways. First one is employee increases their perception that they are appreciated and worthy. This in turn surges their self-esteem and perceived capability to handle with the stressor. For example, I can manage the disaster because my co-worker have insurance on me. Second, social support network technique is social support offers information to aid employees understand, realize and probably eliminate the stressor. For example, social support may decrease a new employee stress since colleagues define methods to manage problematic clients. Lastly, emotional support from others could directly aid to buffer the stress experience. This last fact reveals the impression that misery loves company. Persons seek out and benefit from the emotional support of others when they encounter intimidating circumstances. Social support is an imperative method to manage with stress that everybody can practice by keeping friendships. This contains serving others when they require a little support from the stressors of life. Companies can enable social support by offering opportunities for social communication amongst employees as well as their families. Persons in leadership roles also require to exercise a helpful leadership style when employees work under stressful situations and require this social support. Mentoring relationship with more senior employees might also aid junior employees manage with organizational stressors. Apart from individual and organizational approaches, we do have 4A to deal with stress. Once we do some self-analysis, we can use a method called the 4A. The 4A gives us 4 choices for dealing with a stressor. First A is avoid the stressor. We can try to avoid situation that stresses us out. If watching certain television program causes stress, stop watching them. Spend time with people who help us relax. We can also look at saying no more often if we do not have the time necessary to complete everything we are doing. Second A is alter the stressor. Another option in dealing with stress is to try to alter it. If we cannot avoid it, when changing a situation, we can be more assertive, manage time better, and communicate our own needs and wants better. For example, Karen can look at the things causing her stress, such as her home and school commitments, while she cannot manage the workload. She can examine ways to avoid a heavy workload in the future. If Karen is stressed out about the amount of homework she has and the fact that she needs to clean the house, asking for help from roommates, for example, can help alter the stressor. Often this involves the ability to communicate well. Third A is adapt the stressor. If we are unable to avoid or change the stressor, getting comfortable with the stressor is the way to handle it. Creating our own coping mechanism for the stress and learning to handle it can be an effective way to handle the stress. For example, we can try looking at stressful situation in a positive light. Consider how important the stressor is in the long run and adjust our standards of perfectionism. Fourth A is accept the stressor. Some stressors are unavoidable. We all have to go to work and manage our home life. So learning to handle the things we cannot change by forgiving, developing tolerances, letting go of those things we cannot control is also a way to deal with the stressor. For example, daily routine example, suppose our mother-in-law yearly visit and criticism cause stress. Obviously, we are not able to avoid or alter the stress, but we can adapt to it and accept it. Since we cannot control another person, accepting the stressor, finding ways of dealing with it can help minimize some negative effects of the stress we may experience. So these were some individual and organizational approaches to manage the stress. Now there are some basic strategies to manage the stress. Researchers have found many strategies to manage the stress, like meditating, listening to music, getting enough sleep, drinking black tea, spending time with a funny friend, pampering such as a massage, doing something spiritual, chewing gum, exercising, developing good time management skills, eating a healthy diet, organizations such as keeping workplace organized, picturing yourself relaxed, breathing deeply, social interactions such as spending time with family and friends, and positive thinking. As in this chapter, we have come to know that stress is an adaptive reaction to a state that is observed as puzzling, intimidating to an individual's well-being. Distress defines high stress level that have negative outcomes, while eustress terms the moderately low stress level required to make lively people. The stress experience named the general adaptation syndrome contains going through 3 stages: alarm stage, resistance stage, and exhaustion stage, as these stages we have discussed in the chapter. The stress model displays that stress is produced by stressors. Though the consequences of these stressors hinge on the personal characteristics, stress affects an individual's physiological, psychological well-being and is related with numerous work-related behaviors. Stressors are the reason of stress and contain any environmental circumstances that put a physical and emotional demand on the individual. Stressors are discovered in the physical work environment, employees, several life roles, personal relations, organizational activities, etc. Conflict between work and non-work responsibilities, ties are a recurrent basis of employee stress. Two people exposed to similar stressor might experience dissimilar stress levels since they perceive the situation inversely, have diverse threshold stress levels, or use dissimilar managing strategies. Workaholics, employees with type A behavior patterns inclined to experience more stress than other employees. Deep or continued stress can source physiological signs like high blood pressure, ulcers, sexual dysfunctions, annoyance, coronary heart disease. Apart from physiological, behavioral symptoms like lesser job performance, worse decisions, more workplace mishaps, higher absence, and more workplace violence. Psychologically, stress diminishes job satisfaction and raises irritability, unhappiness, and job burnout. Job burnout mentions to the procedure of emotional exhaustion, sarcasm, and decreased effectiveness resultant from continued contact with stress. It is mostly due to interpersonal role-related stressor and is at most common in serving occupations. Numerous interventions are accessible to handle work-related stress. Some directly eliminate needless stressor or eradicate employees from the stressful situation. Other supports employees change their understanding of the environment so that it is not observed as a grave stressor. Wellness programs inspire employees to shape better physical defense against stress experience. Social support offers emotional, informational, material resource substance to buffer the stress experience. Effective psychological tools for stress management include progressive muscle relaxation, visualization, guided imagery, meditation, hypnosis, biofeedback, and stress inculcation, and cognitive self-talk, conquering procrastination, combating perfectionism, and setting realistic goals. There are some significant points which can be considered. First, stress is inevitable, but through proper coping strategies, it can be managed. Optimum level of stress is good for employees as well as for organizations. The 4A of stress reduction can help to lessen the stress. These 4A's are avoid, alter, adapt, and accept. Relaxation technique can remove the stress. Through some individual and organizational approaches, stress can be managed. Thank you.